Hello YouTube, this is Sir James D. Mitchell coming to you with another video. Today I'm going to be talking about the Call of Duty Black Ops controller for the PlayStation 3. So let me go ahead and turn this around so you can get a better view. Alright, so as you can see, I have the PS3 version of the controller. Right. On the top it says Call of Duty Black Ops. And as you can see, the detail work on it, the symbol here. Sorry if my camera's not that good, it's a flip video. As you can see, you know, nice feel grip on the left and right. Pretty sturdy, you know, not a heavy controller. I believe it was made by Madcats. Yeah, Madcats, which usually a lot of people complain about, saying their product is cheap and stuff. Well, I've only used a few of the Madcats products, and, you know, I like it. You know, a lot of people prefer not to have the controller or prefer not to buy anything with Madcats in it. But, you know, I like it, so, you know, but that's just me. So, anyways, as you can see, you got your the triggers. The L1, R1, box, triangle, circle, X, home button, select, start. Got your D-pad, analog stick. Alright, then on the back you have your combat 2 button and combat 1. And which, what it does is that, let's say if you're using combat 2 button, you can use the combat 2 button as your R3. So instead of clicking R3 like this, you could just click combat 2 and that will be your R3, or you could use box, triangle, and RP. Then for combat 1 you can use L3 instead of this L3. You can use X, 0, and LP. So instead of pushing X like this, you could push X like that. I'm not sure if you can hear it. And also on the front, you have LED on and off. So if you put it on, you know, it's when it's the system's on and stuff. And if you put on LED, the buttons light up. I'm sorry if I hesitate there for a second. Let's see if I can turn off this light. Yeah, so, yeah, it's pretty neat. Let's see, let me turn this back on. You know, I like the controller all in all. The only thing I don't like is the feel of the L1 and R1 buttons. Because they don't really feel like a button, you know, they feel kind of cheapy. That's the only thing I don't like about it. If you're curious how much this controller is, I believe it's sold for $49.99. At your local GameStop, Best Buy I think carries them, Target might carry them. I'm not sure about those two places, but I know GameStop for sure. They have a PC version of this controller, an Xbox 360, and the Nintendo Wii version of the controller. And I don't yet have the Nintendo Wii version of the controller, but I do plan to get it soon. And also, with the PS3 version, you get a USB thumb drive. I mean, not thumb drive, a USB port, you know, for you could use the controller wirelessly. And you also get a cord. I don't know how long the cord is by heart, but it's, you know, pretty long. And I would like to show you a demonstration of the controller while the game is on. But unfortunately, as of this video, my PS3 got the yellow light of death. And so I have to, you know, wait till I get it fixed in order to show you. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said, it costs $49.99 and you can find it at your local GameStop. Or you could try some online sites for cheaper prices. Or maybe cheaper prices. Yeah, but like I said, I give this controller a 4 out of 5.